Hey everyone.
Welcome to the first of hopefully many videos regarding my camper build or trailer build. So I will splice in some video footage to get everyone started on where this is at. So I've posted a short video on Instagram and got a ton of people kind of encouraging and wanting to see more videos on it. So I thought I would just make it easier on everyone and start doing this, put a couple of videos on YouTube. So I'll just, you'll see a time lapse of how all this got started, but this is a 1950s, I believe, New Moon, the Redmond New Moon. I think it was supposed to be just a trailer, not like a trailer home, not a camper. It's the interior and the rear of it are very similar to the camper and or the trailer in the long trailer, if any of you have seen that. If you haven't, I suggest you go check it out. It's pretty cool. It's an old movie. But the interior was pretty similar to that movie. And upon further inspection and getting into this thing, it was just overran by rodents for, I don't know, seems like probably the better part of the last 50 years. And it was setting out in the field out in the middle of Colorado here. So I was fortunate enough that the gentleman that had it just wanted it off his property. He's cleaning the property up and wanted it gone. So I got it for free. And it came with this new wood stove and the piping for it and everything. So I think it was a good deal or a good find. The more we get into this camper, the more we see, basically, I'll just take you around and show you. So the interior is pretty bad. Like there's just nests inside the walls, mold. The old wiring would all have to go. The insulation would have to go. Here's a wall that they built for a toilet area. They had a composting toilet. But if you can see all this on the floor, this is all pack rat urine and feces. The black tarry looking stuff is all urine. And the little pellets, of course, are this pack rat feces. So it is everywhere. There's not a place in here that's not been touched by it, or it's just, it's at this point in the process, I've kind of come to the conclusion that while I will try to save some of the fixtures like the latches, and I'll try to even save some of the paneling on top and reuse, because it's not all terrible, but it's appearing to be harder to get out than I thought. So we'll see how much of it gets reused. But this is it. This is at this point, it looks like almost all of it's going to get tore down to the frame and probably built back up into a tiny house form, but it's a trailer frame and not a camper frame. So it's a 1950s trailer frame. So it's oddly sturdy. So I'll have to go around and weld some reinforcements in, build off of this frame, I believe, using what materials I can. But it doesn't look like I'm gonna be able to leave it in original shape the way I was hoping to, just because if you're putting time and money into it, I'm sure I could get some modern reproduction windows that would be more efficient. But the truth is, I've got some windows for a tiny house build, and this frame is just too good not to use. It's got some like drop spindle axles. Yeah, it's already set up perfect to build on. So I'm just gonna have to bite the bullet and destroy this thing and keep what I can. Take it apart as peacefully as possible, but So I'll post regular videos of the updates. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. I think everyone will probably agree that this is best just to get rid of all of this and start all over. And there's a potential to reuse some of the material. The sheet metal on the outside will mostly get reused. So my plan is to weld reinforcements onto the frame and then do just sheet metal, almost maybe just rivet sheet metal on top of that, and then frame and insulate on top of that after I've sealed it all up for water, and then build probably regular 2x4 walls and build it taller and have a lot more head height. So the beauty of having these drop spindle axles is you can build like 13 feet high and still legally tow. So right now we're right at or less than 2 feet off the ground at the floor level now. So I'll go up a little bit from that, but I'll still be able to have quite tall ceilings. And then I'll show you guys some of the stuff I've already picked up for the build. So check back in. This is the first of many. The video quality hopefully will get better. This is just my phone. I don't know video editing or anything, so I'll have to learn that as I go. But so here it is. I'll show you it's pretty gross. So I had to wear a respirator for all the cleanup. All this is from pack rats. Yeah, and there's trash bags full already of pack rat stuff that I've taken out of here. So here's what I've got so far. There's an old sink that was in there. It's kind of disgusting. I don't know if it'll get cleaned up or not. So the old furnace. And so what's gone to the trash so far? All of the interior. So, but here's the outside of it. You can tell that at least part of it was the plain metal, sheet metal, so. It's supposed to split right at 30 feet long. So yeah, that's gonna be the future home. So yeah, guys, just leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. Also, any links or suggestions to build ideas? I'm open to anything at the moment. At this point, I just know I'm gonna use this wood stove, and I'm gonna use some windows that I've already purchased. So I'm gonna try to reuse these interior doors. So yeah, if you could just leave me a comment, let me know what you think. Any suggestions for build ideas or links to cool ideas. Right now, all I know is it basically has to come down to the frame, and I'm gonna have to rebuild up. So that's the reality of it. It's still better than, in my opinion, it's still better than buying a big trailer frame, because like utility trailer frame, because it'd be hard to get one in this size. And I don't plan on building with a ton of interior weight. It's going to be mostly wide open, so I'm not too concerned with the weight. And this was free, so if I can reuse any of the material and get a free frame, then it's a win. So so if you want, just follow along for what this video is worth. I mean, you could like it if you want, but subscribe, and we can see this entire journey. It's probably going to take through the spring. Maybe, as you can see, we've got snow most outside. So yeah, all right, well, that's enough for today. So just this is going to be a disgusting project.